Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Good morning, GI family and friends. So glad that you decided to join us this morning on Bishop Emmett Hall YouTube channel. I just wanted to get on and do a welcome. If this is your first time, I want to say welcome. GI family, I want to say welcome. Dr. Hall, myself, and Bishop, we're all still praying for you. And I don't know about you, but I feel so blessed. You know, I haven't been the best deacon or Wallace. But God, because of his grace and his mercy, I'm still here and I can welcome you and say thank you for hanging in there with us, the GI family. We want to continue to pray for Bishop. We thank God that he brought Bishop through two major surgeries. The doors of the church will be opened up soon. We want you to just hold on. We're going to come in and we're going to blow the roof off of GI. So, let's get ready to hear from God through the man of God. And don't forget now, the third Sunday, we'll be opening up the doors of the GI. We at 8461 South San Pedro. We start at 10 o'clock promptly, okay? So we're looking for y'all to be here. And as Bishop say, don't meet me here, but beat me here. So I'll be here, Bishop will be here, Dr. Hall will be here. And GI family, we just looking forward. We so glad to see you back in the house of the Lord. Now let's get ready to hear from God through the man of God. All right, God bless you. We love you and see you soon.
You. I am so excited about the grace of God, what God is doing in our lives. Man, this first Sunday of September, I'm back, and I'm rocking. And I'm glad that I'm back. Man, I just believe in 2 weeks we're coming back in. Okay, the third Sunday in September, I believe, if the Lord say the same, it's still tentative that we're coming back in to worship. So I want to see everyone. I want to see you, your family members, your coworkers, your friends. I want to see everyone. And we're going to have an exciting time in the Lord. Okay, in the Lord. And still wear your mask. Things are still looking bad. And even though this is the first Sunday of September, you still have to wear your mask because COVID-19 is not playing. They got different viruses out there and variants out there. And so we want to remember to stay protected, okay? Stay protected. And listen, real talk. If we can get rid of these negative people, if we can somehow get rid of these negative people in our lives, we will be all right. Somebody hit me and say, Bishop, I need to get rid of a few negative people in my life. I need to get rid of a few negative spirits in my life that's hanging around. If we can get rid of these negative people with these negative attitudes, okay, we'll be all right. With these negative plans and negative agendas, man, we will be all right. And so we're going to be praying about that. Everybody that's hanging around you with negative talk, in the name of Jesus, disappear. Everybody hanging around you with negative thinking, in the name of Jesus, disappear. Everybody hanging around you with negative activities, in the name of Jesus, disappear. And so I'm just excited about what Jesus is going to do this month. He's going to do some great things this month. And think about it. We're moving closer. Okay, we're moving closer to opening up. Huh, come on, somebody get a Lord a hand of praise. We're moving closer to opening up, and I just want to thank God for everything. I've been down for a while, major surgeries for a while, couldn't walk for months, but God has shown His mercy and His grace on the bishop. So I'm back and I'm doing great. And I want to thank you all for all the blessings, all the prayers that you prayed for Dr. Hall and I. And I'm doing great and I thank God for that. And I just believe that the hand of God is on this ministry and He's going to do some great things. And all of you that's been giving, really giving to the ministry of your time, your talent, and expressing your finance to keep everything going. Real talk, we've been out of this building. We haven't been together collectively in about 18 months. That's almost 2 years, about 18 months. I haven't seen some of you since last year. How you doing? I hope you're doing well. Haven't seen a lot of you since last year. And God is really upholding our ministry, undergirding our ministry. And so I just want to personally thank every one of you for every penny, every nickel, every dime, every quarter, every half a dollar, okay? Every 75 cent, every dollar, $5, $10, $20, okay? $50 and the Benjamin. All of you that have collectively put money into this ministry over 18 months to keep us afloat. Amen, to keep us afloat. Everybody been doing bad. Everybody have been hit by this pandemic. Everyone has been hit by this pandemic. But all of you that has been faithful to the word of God, been faithful to your tithing and your offering, God has something brand new for you. Listen to you, Bishop. God has something brand new for you. And each and every one of you that has been every week taking care of your pastor, your bishop, every week taking care for 18 month. You, every week you haven't missed by taking care of me. God has something up His sleeve for you. And so I just want to say I love you, and Dr. Hall love you, and our family love you, and we've just been doing a great job for 18 months. Devion has been doing a fantastic job, man, 18 months. I knew he had it in him, but I congratulate him in the background making all this possible. He's been doing a great job for 18 months. Ebony in the background doing a great job for 18 months. I thank God for our singers, Dr. Hall and Jade and the rest of them been doing a great job for 18 months. We're getting ready to go in, I hope, in 2 weeks. Deacon Wallace and Bell and Brother President, they've been doing a great job holding me up for 18 months, even when I was down. They'll come by the house and make sure I was all right. And so I just thank God for all of those that have did, that have performed the reading of the scripture and the welcomes. You have been doing a great job. And especially, like I say, those that's behind the scene, okay, financing with your nickels. I want to thank God for you, okay? And all the ones that say we wasn't going to make it, I'm praying for you. All the ones that were so negative, I'm praying for you. Amen. And so I just want to make sure that everything is safe, okay? Tentatively, we're opening up on the third Sunday, okay, of this month, September. So we just pray that you know, nothing really just jumps out at us where we have to move it back. So it's a possibility now that we might move it back. I'm letting you know it's a possibility that we might move it back, but tentatively we coming with it, all right? And we want you there. And wear your mask, okay? And don't act like you haven't been out to the store, okay, to the drive-in, to the mall, all right, getting shoes, to the dentist, okay, getting your hair done, getting your nails done. Don't act like you haven't been out now. You've been out, going over your friend's house, going over your children's house. So don't make church as if a strange thing now. Oh, I got to go to church and everybody panicking. You better bring your happy cell phone up in here. You better bring your happy cell phone up in here and get you a corner and sit in your corner and praise God in your corner. All right? God bless you. Let's get to the word of God. I'm excited. Let's get to the word of God. Get to the word of God. And like I say, I thank each and every one of you for praying for me when I was down. And Dr. Hall did a super job. She did a super job. Okay, she did a super job. And I thank you all for your praying for her. Pray her strength. And Ebony and Dr. Hall was on some Tuesdays, been covering for me. I'm going to have to give them a collar. I'm going to get him a collar because they was doing, how many know that Ebony and Dr. Hall was doing a great job on Tuesday? And we thank Sister Cooper and Mother Hill. They've been holding up that that prayer line. They've been doing a great job along with Deacon Wallace. They've been doing a great job. And so we thank you all for it. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this mighty word. Bless me that I may be able to deliver the word of God, that somebody might be saved, that somebody might be helped, that somebody might be revived. We thank you. We bless you in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen. Let's go to the word of God. Let's go to the word of God. Let's go to Roman. Roman, we done valeted over this passage of scripture. Roman, the 8th chapter. Okay? Roman, the 8th chapter. God bless you. I love y'all too. I love y'all. Somebody say, I love you, Bishop. You look good, Bishop. I love you too. I love you too. You know, I love y'all too. Okay. Roman, the 8th chapter. I want to see you in service on the third Sunday. I want to see you at 10 o'clock, 8461 South San Pedro in the city of Los Angeles. Say it again, Bishop. Slow down. You're talking too fast. 8461 South San Pedro. Okay. Los Angeles. Okay. And I'd like to see you here at 10 o'clock. Roman 8th chapter and the 28th verse. And we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God and to them who are called according to his purpose. Thank you for that word, God. Thank you for that word. We're going to move on the side of talking about a season of goodness. Man. A season of goodness, because it has to come. Good gonna come out of this pandemic. You know, all of you that have been hit by that COVID-19 virus, that bug that have plagued your family, have plagued your loved ones, have plagued your friends, have plagued your coworkers, And even some of our members have been hit by that COVID-19 virus, that bug. God is going to bring some good out of it. I just believe that he is. I just believe that he is, okay? And so we're going to talk about a season of, that's right, goodness. This letter is more formal than Apostle Paul's other letters to the church of Jesus Christ. Roman set forth the doctrine of justification by faith and its ramifications in a systematic way. God, I feel God already. See, in September, I feel God this first Sunday. God wants us to understand that everything that we do, we have to do it by faith. Whichever way we move, we have to move by faith. Everything is projected through the spirit of faith. Romans chapter 8 talks about expected living and God's sovereignty over every aspect of our life. We must understand that God is in control of every aspect of our life. Whatever you're facing, whatever you're going through, God already knows. He already has a solution for it. How you feel, how you think, how you operate, God already knows. Real talk. God knows your next step. He know what you will do, and he know what you won't do. Let me point out some sovereignties into this ordinary text. Note the fact, my brothers and sisters, we must understand this. Number one, we know that God causes all things. That's the first point. We know that God causes all things. What you talking about, Bishop? Well, the verse says in the 28th verse, I hope you have your Bibles with me to follow me. The 28th verse of Romans, the 8th chapter says, all things work together for good. Not some things, not a few things, but the Bible says all things. Somebody hit me and say, Bishop, all things are coming together for my good. Come on, hit me and say, all things are coming together, Bishop, for my good. That's what the word of God says. And you have to learn, you've been in church long enough, you have to learn how to stand on the word of God. You have to learn how to lean on the word of God. You have to learn how to depend on the word. I'm getting excited. Of God. You have to learn how to rely on the word of God. You have to learn how at this time in your Christian walk, you have to learn how to trust the word of God. Many Christians, my brothers and sisters, I'm looking down at my book and I'm reading the Bible, and I discovered that many Christians, my brothers and sisters, have never totally committed their lives to the will of God. A lot of us have never totally committed our lives to the will of God. Not understanding that God causes everything to formulate, my brothers and sisters, in this world. This is God's world. This is not our world. In a sense, he's the creator of this world. Okay, this is Satan's system. I need to be doctrinally correct. This is Satan's system in which we live in. But when we're talking about the cosmos, that belongs to God. Are you with me here? What you mean by the cosmos? Bishop, break it down. Don't try to get theologically sound on. What you mean by the cosmos? What I mean by the cosmos, I'm saying that the moon belongs to God. I'm saying that the sun belong to God. The S-U-N belong to God. What are you saying? I'm saying that the stars that leaps in the atmosphere, that belongs to God. What you saying? I'm talking about the sea that God has commanded. Don't you go past your banks. You can roar all you want to. That sea belongs to God. That's what I'm talking about. Amen. God causes everything to formulate in this cosmos, in this world. It is God who causes all things to shift into action. Let me say that again. It is God who causes all things to shift into actions, my brother and sister. Apostle Paul, I told you to break your Bible. I told you to break your Bible. Apostle Paul, the great Apostle Paul said it like this. He said, and we know. Uh-huh. And we know. I feel mighty good, y'all. I feel mighty good. God's been good to me. God's been good to me. I don't know how you feel about it. But when you go through two major surgeries, like your bishop have gone through since May, amen, two major surgeries since May, and I'm still getting around, and I still got it, and I'm still saying, Lord, I just want to say thank you for blessing me. I go to my doctor say, man, you 6 or 8 months ahead of where you're supposed to be. That's not me. That's God. That's the Lord Jesus Christ. It's not me. Healing belongs to God. And so the great Apostle Paul said, and I had to throw that testimony in there. Y'all know that, huh? That praise report in there. You know that. I'm going to brag on Jesus. I don't care what you say. I'm going to brag on Jesus. Okay? Because Jesus sometimes brags on me. So I got to brag on him. I got to give him his ups. All right? Now the great Apostle Paul said, and we know. What is it that we know? In a tactical sense, what is it that we know? Because the word of God say, and we know. Paul say, and we know. Okay? And Romans, the 8th chapter and the 32nd verse. Come on, go there with me. Romans, the 8th chapter and the 32nd verse says it this way. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Freely give us all things. What you mean, Bishop? Well, you just got to see and understand what the word of God is talking about. Okay? We understand that the favor of dominion is in the hands of God. You have to understand that. We have to understand, my brothers and sisters, that opportunities are in the hand of God. We have to understand that wealth is in the hand of God. We have to understand that purpose is in the hand of God. We must understand that inner strength, our inner strength, where we get our inner strength from, is in the hand of God. We have to understand that wisdom, the wisdom that we have, is in the hand of God. Excuse me. We have to understand, my brothers and sisters, that blessings, those blessings, even those spiritual blessings in spiritual places, in high places, okay, are in the hands of God. We must understand, my brothers and sisters, that our happiness, you not understanding me, is in the hand of God. We must understand that our cheerfulness is in the hand of God. We must understand that our riches are in the hand of God. We must understand that our life, get ready to get out of here, is in the hand of God. Every step that we take, God has already ordered that step. Listen to me, real talk. Every decision that we make, God has already ordered that decision. Are you with me here? We must understand the sovereignty of God. God has a permissive will, and God has a divine will. God is going to always carry out his divine will. That's just the way it is. He's God all by himself. There is none other God but him. Okay? He is the only Savior. That's it. So he's going to carry, listen to Bishop, he's going to carry out his divine will in your life because he's God. On the other hand, he has a permissive will. What you mean, Bishop, a permissive will? God allow things to happen. He just step back and allow it to happen. That's the way you want to walk. He allows it to happen. That's who you want to marry, even if it work out or don't work out. That's the way it happened. You want to have one child, two child, three children, five children, or whatever. That's the way he allowed it to happen. That's his permissive will. Okay? Some things God permits to happen, but it's not in his divine will for our life. But one thing we know, whatever God allows to happen in our life, it's going to work out. Oh, good. It's going to work out for our good, whatever, whichever way it goes. We're going to go over some bumps. We're going to hit some anxieties, stress going to come. Come on, somebody. Embarrassment is going to come through all of that. Grief is going to come through. You're going to have some illness, some sickness. It's going to rise its ugly head. Some sadness is going to come through. Some suffering is going to show up. Some tortures is on the sideline ready to fight. Trouble's going to come in our life. Cursing is going to be there. Come on. Somebody, wretchedness is going to show up, depression is going to show up, but through it all, God is going to work it out for our good. Even if it's his divine will or if it's his permissive will, he's going to work it out for our good. That's the way we need to look at it. We must understand, my brothers and sisters, we must remember God will personally work out everything for our good. That's the kind of God that we serve. He's going to work it out. Now look into the text. Note the facts. A, God orchestrates our destiny. God orchestrates our destiny. The number one pointer was, we know that God causes all things. Now, the pointer under that is, God orchestrates our destiny. What you talking about, Bishop? Well, I'm glad you asked. God orchestrates our sufferings for our good. Listen to me, young lady, I'm talking to you. Listen to me, young man, I'm talking to you. Listen to me, child, I'm talking to you. Listen to me, children, I'm talking to you. God wants to speak into your spirit, okay? And God wants to speak positive things into your spirit. God don't want to speak negative things into your spirit. God don't want negative talk to go into your spirit. You're not walking with me. God is not trying to operate with negative thinking. He don't want that in your spirit. God is talking positive things. And we must understand that God even orchestrates our suffering for our good. God orchestrates our adversities. Come on, somebody. I'm going to preach you the word of God for our good. Whatever you're going through right now, and I know there are some of you sitting there that are going through some adversities. There are some of you sitting there or standing there, laying there, listening to me this morning that are going through some illness and some sickness. Hello, somebody. There are someone standing there whose finances is not where it need to be, where you can be comfortable in life. There's someone that is sitting there, standing there watching me today, whose job is up and down. You don't know which way it may go. There's someone that's watching me this morning who is so afraid, who have been just tore up, amen, in the mind concerning this COVID-19, and they so afraid to even go outdoors, even on the porch without a mask on. because they think COVID-19 is in the air. There is someone, amen, that's listening to me, that's dealing with, my brothers and sisters, some adversities. But I'm here to bring you some good news. God orchestrates our adversities for our good. God orchestrates our discomfort for our good. That's the kind of God that we serve. God orchestrates, listen to me, Bishop, real talk. He orchestrates our challenges for our good. That's the kind of God that we serve. He orchestrates our affliction, all the things that's bothering us, all the things that we can't sleep at night, or we wake up at 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning sweating and afraid and frightened. God is orchestrating all of that for our good. God is orchestrating even our plans that we didn't even include him. He orchestrating all of that for our good. God is orchestrating all the decisions that we make, good decision, bad decision, indifferent decision. He is orchestrating all of that, even though 99% of us, but I'll bring it down a little bit, 80% of us did not include him in the plans, in our decisions. How many of us included God in our decision when we got married? How many of us included God in our decision when we got the job we got, or whoever we hooked up with, or the children that we had, or the moves that we made? How many of us included God really in our decision? With the boyfriend you with now, with the boo you with now, how many of you included God in that? I'm messing with you now. In that decision. Now it's somebody that's getting ready to make a major decision. I don't know who you are. There's numerous of you out there that's getting ready to make a life-changing decision. Have you really sat down and got into the Word of God concerning your decision and not everybody else's and what they think? Your decision and not what everybody else say what you ought to do, but your decision. Have you really seek God concerning the decision that you are getting ready to make right now? Have you sought God? Have you talked to God about it? Have you went in prayer about it? The action that you're getting ready to shift into. Have you talked to God? Because this can be a season of goodness. God, should I go or should I stay? God, should I walk or should I stop? God, should I get up or should I sit down? God, should I pursue or don't pursue? Decisions. Please make sure you done consult God about it. God, my brothers and sisters, is the orchestrates. God orchestrates our worship for his good. For our good. He orchestrates, my brothers and sisters, our life events for our good. That's the kind of God that we serve. He orchestrates our prayer life. If you have a prayer life, real talk, when the last time you prayed? I'm not talking about over your food. I'm talking about when the last time you prayed. All of you that are married out there, when was the last time you put your hands together with your husband or with your wife and say, baby, let's pray about this decision? Or let's just pray together that we make some good decisions. When was the last time? Come on, don't play with me. You know, when was the last time? All you single folks out there, before you made your next step, your next decision, when was the last time you talked to God about it? All you divorcees, single mothers, single parents, single fathers, when was the last time you prayed about the decision that you're going to make? Because this can be a season of goodness for you. The adversary don't want things to go well for you. Listen to your bishop. Come on, somebody. The adversary, real talk, don't want things to go right for your situation. He don't want things to go right for your family. He don't want things to go right for your children. He want to wreck the children. He want them against one another. He want the husband and the wife against one another. He want the grandchildren and the grandmother and the grandchildren and the grandfather against one another. He wants you at odds at work. He don't want no peace on your job. Real talk, he don't. He wants you fussing and fighting and digging. Come on, family, about your finance. Every time finance come up, you're fussing and fighting and jawing and jacking one another. Oh, I'm preaching this moment. Do I have a witness here? I'm in somebody's house. I'm in somebody's business. Do I have a witness? And so that's the way God operates. When was the last time you sit down and prayed about it? Say, God, should I make this move or should I make this move? God, my brothers and sisters, orchestrates our connections for our good. He orchestrates our stress level for our good. That's the kind of God that we serve. God is causing all these things to bring believers to a real sense of salvation. That's what it's all about. You being saved. All this gonna come together that you'll be a stronger believer in the Lord Jesus Christ. What you mean? What you mean, Bishop? Well, I'm getting ready. Good. I feel good. What you talking about, Bishop? God knows how to bring some sadness into your life that you have to call on him. God knows how to bring illness and sickness into your life or the life of a loved one for you to call on him. God knows how to bring embarrassment into your life for you to call on him. God knows how to orchestrate trouble your way so you'll kneel down and have to call on God. God knows how, my brothers and sisters, to bring the stresses of this world into your life, that you'll have to call on him. And the reason why he wants you to call on him is so that he can work out all of that mess that we done got our own selves in. The reason why you're in the mess that you're in is not because of your daddy. It's not because of your mother. Not because of your husband, your wife, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your children, your grandchildren. It's not because of that. You made those decisions. And so God has brought all that stuff together just to work it out for your good. Just so that God can be glorified. So that you can point back to God. And not away from God. I'm feeling God. Good God Almighty. We must remember, my brothers and sisters, as I leave you this morning. I hate to leave you because I feel so good knowing that God has blessed me and knowing that your prayers has overcome the prayers of the enemy. I hate to leave you. But Deacon Wallace, I got to leave you, baby. Mother Ross, I have to leave you. Good God Almighty, I have to leave you, Brother President. I got to leave you because we got to get out of here because I want to have the communion right after this service. Did y'all catch that? I want to have communion right after this service. So I don't want to keep you long. I can't wait till I get back to church and have my mic in my hand and have my organist over there following me and having the whole crowd of people saying, Bishop, come on, let's go to church. Is it anybody here who's ready to go to church? Good God Almighty. I don't know who it is that's going to be here on the third Sunday. But if the Lord say the same, your boy going to be here on the third Sunday with his dancing shoes on. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to dance and pick him up and put him down. But I can still shake a little bit because I'm going to be saying, church, if I can get it out that the Lord has brought me through some difficult times. Nobody understand the times that the Lord has brought your boy through. Some rough times, some terrible times, some sad times. But if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I don't think that I can make it. Is it anybody out there can stand in the same wagon that I'm standing in and say, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I wouldn't have made it this far? Because I understand that the hands of God has shown me some mercy. Are you going to walk with me? I understand that the hand of God have shown his power. I understand that the hand of God has shown his favor in my life. I understand, my brothers and sisters, that the hand of God has shown his protection in my life. I understand that the hand of God has shown us his comfort. The hand of God has shown us his authority. The hand of God has shown us his healing. The hand of God has shown us his peace. Ain't God all right? The hand of God have shown us his deliverance. Ain't God good? The hand of God have shown us his gifts. The hand of God have shown us his purpose. Ain't God all right? The hand of God God have shown us his direction. So Paul is saying, all things work together for our good. Ain't God good? I heard as I close, you know I got to close, but I heard folks talking about Jesus, good God Almighty, and Jesus was concerned. And Jesus said, good God Almighty, who do they say that the Son of Man am? Good God Almighty. And some of the apostles and some of the disciples were saying, well, some say you're John the Baptist, some say you're Elias, some say you're Jeremiah, some say you're the other prophet. But Jesus said, who do you say that I am? What are you saying, Bishop? All of the things that you've been going through this pandemic, all of the things that you've been facing through COVID-19, who do you say that Jesus is? Come on, talk to me, somebody. And I heard Peter say, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. Ain't God all right? Simon Pajona, flesh and blood did not reveal it to you, but my Father which is in heaven. Ain't God good? Say it. God is he's a great God, a wonderful, wonderful Savior. Amen. I thank him because he didn't make salvation difficult. He did not make salvation hard. They that believe on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And I'm glad about it. And I'm not going to forget. He died on Calvary. He was buried. And he rose on the third day. And whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. So all this is about salvation. I love y'all. I care about you. All of you that want to be a part of our ministry virtually, because this is getting ready to come to an end. Yes. You looking at me on your iPhone or your iPad or your TV. And one more week, after next week, this is getting ready to come to an end. If God say the same, you're going to have to come in service and prove who you are. You just gonna stand with God, stand with God. You just not gonna stand with God, don't stand with God. It's up to you. But I'm like Joshua, for me and my house, we gonna serve the Lord. For me and my house, the church is opening, we going down to the church house. Because if God can protect me at the grocery store, he can protect me at the church now. If God can protect me at the movies, he can protect me at the church. If God can protect me at the game, the football game, the basketball game, now he can protect me at the church. I don't know who's been vaccinated, but your boy, amen, real talk, I've been vaccinated. And I'm trusting God. With people that's been vaccinated still catch COVID, what? That's right. But it's not going to kill you. It's not going to leave you all tore up, kidneys and all that. And so I'm vaccinated. I'm going to still have my mask on. But that's your decision, what goes into your body. But I just made the decision that God is going to make everything all right, because they got all these crazy theories out there. Can't say nothing about that. But one thing I do know for sure, if you accept Jesus as your personal Savior, when you close your eyes, you're going to wake up in the morning in his presence. And it's going to be a good thing. It's going to be a good season. Amen. It's going to be a season of goodness. Why? Because he's going to work all things out for your good. Don't click me off. He's going to work everything out for your good. We've been out 18 months now. And like I said, this tentative, if God say the same in 2 weeks, we're going to be in this house. We can be worshiping. You could come that want to come. You won't see me on you know, YouTube no more, because I'm not doing YouTube and in the church and Facebook. And in the church, you still going to sit at home. No, it ain't going down that way. If you're going to see your bishop, you're going to hear your bishop preach, I see you here. Okay? I will see you here. All right. God bless you. This Monday is a holiday. Are you staying home? Or are you gone already? Tomorrow is a holiday. Labor Day. How many staying at home, inside, masked up, around, not around nobody? Okay? And so we're going to have a wonderful time. I thank God for you allowing me to come into your presence. I thank God for you. Thank God for all your prayers for my family. And continue to pray for my family, because, you know, everybody got family feud going on, not just my family, your family too. So, you know, doing this family feud, y'all pray for my family and I pray for yours. Okay? God bless you. This is the way we